Bonjour tout le monde. I am honored to be here in Latvia at Camp Atachi with my friend Prime Minister Kariņš. I'm especially grateful to be able to visit with the women and men of the Canadian Armed Forces who are doing extraordinary work leading this battle group. I arrived in Latvia this morning and met first with President Rinkevič and then with Krišjānis, the Prime Minister. Thank you so much for welcoming us today, my friend, and for being such incredible hosts to the Canadian Armed Forces members here. Lors de nos rencontres, on a discuté du resserrement des liens entre nos pays, y compris de l'accroissement du commerce. Les relations entre nos deux pays ont toujours été solides, mais elles sont aujourd'hui plus importantes que jamais. C'est pourquoi on agrandit notre ambassade à Riga. Our countries have strong people-to-people ties and also meaningful historical ties. Canada was the first G7 nation to ratify Latvia's accession to NATO, and 32 years ago we were the first G7 member to recognize the restoration of Latvia's independence. The sovereignty of nations, their territorial integrity, the rights of people to choose their own future is at the heart of why our two countries have come together today. In my meetings with both the President and the Prime Minister, our top priorities were support for Ukraine and action we need to continue to take to deter Russia's ongoing and unacceptable aggression. When Russia first invaded Ukraine in 2014, NATO allies mobilized and formed Operation REASSURANCE to establish a strong military presence in Eastern Europe. Canada stepped up to lead a battle group here in Latvia on NATO's eastern flank, beginning in 2017. To date, hundreds of Canadian Armed Forces members have trained and served alongside soldiers from across the alliance. Well, today, I am announcing that we are going to more than double our presence, deploying up to an additional 1,200 members of the Canadian Armed Forces to serve and defend democracy and the rule of law. These additional personnel will reinforce and enhance our land, maritime, and air capabilities and support special operations in Central and Eastern Europe. This is part of a $2.6 billion investment we are announcing today, which also includes the purchase of critical weapons systems and support for intelligence and cyber activities. Le renouvellement et l'élargissement de l'opération Réassurance permettront au Canada de contribuer de manière concrète au renforcement le plus important de la défense collective de l'OTAN depuis une génération. Pour donner suite à l'engagement qu'on a pris lors du sommet de Madrid l'année dernière, on va travailler avec nos alliés pour que le groupe tactique de la présence avancée renforcée en Lettonie devienne une brigade. This is just one more way that Canada is stepping up to support our allies and standing up against the Kremlin's aggression. Canada has helped lead the charge in putting in place one of the toughest sanctions regimes ever. We've provided billions of dollars in military, humanitarian, and financial support to Ukrainians in their heroic defense against Russian invaders. Canada and all countries must be clear that Russia's unprovoked war on an independent country, on a free and democratic Ukraine, is a threat to freedom, international law, human rights, and the whole set of shared democratic values that generations of soldiers have fought to defend. I look forward to meeting with CAF members on the base here and thank them for their sacrifice and their service. This is Canada's largest overseas mission, and we are here because European security is important to Canadian security. As soldiers in Operation REASSURANCE, you have an important role to play in defending and deterring the very serious threats to peace and stability that we're seeing today. And you do it thousands of miles from home, away from your family and loved ones. So thank you. J'ai été frappé par le courage et la solidarité des membres de ce groupement tactique que vous dirigez ici en Lettonie. Les Canadiens sont fiers de servir aux côtés d'hommes et de femmes originaires d'un tiers des pays membres de l'OTAN, à savoir l'Albanie, la Tchéquie, l'Islande, l'Italie, le Monténégro, la Macédoine du Nord, la Pologne, la Slovaquie, la Slovénie, l'Espagne et bientôt le Danemark. Et maintenant que la Finlande fait partie de l'OTAN et que la Suède y adhérera bientôt, on espère que de nouveaux amis se joindront aux membres de ce groupement tactique incroyablement solide et diversifié. This enhanced forward presence is the most multinational in all of NATO, and this is a testament to the incredible support of all these nations and Canada's belief in strength through multilateralism. As Krišjānis pointed out, this is the way forward in modern defense. Almost a dozen countries from across NATO are cooperating, training, and working alongside each other and learning valuable lessons from each other that make our collective defense stronger. One thing we always say in Canada is that diversity is a source of strength. Well, this battle group here in Kampadachi is proof of that, and the work we're doing together is incredibly valuable to NATO's future. To all the troops, I want to say your service together in this mission is a great symbol for all to see that democratic nations are as strong and united as ever. NATO unity is more important than it ever has been, as we're faced with a foe that still believes that might should make right, and that wants to destroy everything that we've built. Well, as allies, we draw our strength from our belief in peace, stability, and the rights of people to be free to choose their own future. And I know that this is what we will focus on at the NATO Leaders Summit this week. These beliefs are what we stand for and what the troops here at Camp Padachi tirelessly defend. Les Canadiens et nos alliés et partenaires sont incroyablement reconnaissants pour tout ce que vous faites. Thank you for your service. Thank you all for being here today.